Hi, my name is Sergey Malina, and today I will be sketching a portrait to teach you, using my special system, how to improve your drawing skills in a very effective way. An image on this side, and we're going to have an exactly the same size square on this side, and we're going to be using the numbers and the letters here only as coordinates. We're not going to be using the grid system, because grid system does not teach you how to improve exactness of your sketch. So what we're going to look at, we're going to try to put it, and it's very easy to position at that level. So we're going to put a line over here that it would represent where the eyebrows are, and then we're going to put another line here which represents the bottom of the nose and the line for the mouth. That's very good to start with that, because it positions all the main proportions. Then what we'll do, we're going to try to do a sketch of the whole face. So on this side, we're going to look how much of a space we have here, a negative space over here, and we're going to do that. Then we're going to go and we could look at the level 3 over here, and it's going to be the bottom of the ear. We're going to position this, and from here we're going to go, and very, very important that we look down this way and try to judge the distance, which is about halfway from here to here. We're going to go this way, then it turns. We're going to look at the direction. If we were to continue this line, where would it fall? So we're going to look at the direction right over here. And then we see the neck, which is very close to the level of A. And then it turns over here. So that gives us a very good negative space on this side. Then we're going to continue. What we could look at, we could look at the bottom of the chin, which is very, very close, and is somewhere over here. And then it goes up over here, and another line that repeats this and this going up, and this line goes from the level C. So we're going to go like this, and from this level we're going to go up like this and to the level of the ear. Again, what we're going to look at, we're going to look at this at the 3 and to line up the ears like that. So it's always very, very important to check every placement. So from here we're going to look over here and like this, and what we see hair on this side, which is approximately shaped like this, and it's also dark, so we're going to shade it right away. Once you shade it, you could see shape better. We're going to use cross hatching, so we're going to go in a different direction. So we're going to go like this, and then we could go a little bit in different directions like this, so that creates a really nice cross hatching technique. On this side, we're going to go and again check approximately over here, and then it goes down like this, and then we see a bit of the shirt, and all of this also goes its inner shadow like this. So we're going to block it in, so it's much easier to judge. So we already have the shape of the face. The very next, what we should be doing, we should look at the width of the nose. So nose is positioned approximately between the A and B. So what we're going to do, we're going to go and then put like this would be the nose on this side and the nose on this side. The bottom of the nose is a V-like shape like this, and we could shade a little bit like this here, and a V-like shape on this side. So we're going to go like this, and then we're going to follow this shape going up, and it goes approximately, try not to do it with every curve possible right away, and we'll shade a little bit going all the way to this side of the nose, and then we're going to move up like this to the eyebrow like this, and we're going to do the same on this side. And we're going to try to shade this a little this way. What we could do at this stage, we could erase this line over here because it was a preliminary line. We don't need it anymore. And we're going to try to position the eyes. So eyes would approximately be on that level right here. And they always line up with the side of the nose. So we're going to go like this, and we're going to place, this is going to be the beginning of one eye, and this is going to be the beginning of the second eye right here. Then we're going to look at the shape of the eye. First it's going to go like this, then it turns a little bit this way like this, and then it comes down. It's very important to pay attention to the line, so the line could be thin like this, or the line could be wider like this size. So in this particular case, the lines are wider like this, so we're going to shade them. Once we do the top of the eye, we should right away do the eyelid, because it's very close to the eye, and we're going to shade all of this so we could see it a little better. in this. And then we could eyebrow. With eyebrow, it's also very important to have a look at how much of the shadow. It's about that much of a shadow. And then it turns over here, shaded, blended edges. And we're going to go over here. From this point, we're going to try to judge, and this would be a negative space. So we have that much of the dark and that much of the light. So we're going to put this first, and then see the negative shape from here to here. We're going to go to this, and we're also going to judge how much is left on this side, about that much. And what we're going to do, we're going to shade that like this. And come back to shade a little more to give a little softer look to it. This and shade on this side and a little bit darker this here. Then what we should do, we should put a little bit of definition to the bottom of the eye. This and this. So now we have a placement of the eye and the nose. We could come back. It's a very good idea to jump from one area to another because your eye gets used to detail and you stop seeing any problems with it. So as I was doing the eye, then I moved to the nose, and from the nose I could move to the mustache area, which would be going in that direction first, like this. Stop over here, and again, very important to look down and check that it would be in the place over here. We're going to shade this, and then we're going to go to this area. We're going to look at this shape right here. It comes down like this, going this way like that. When you shade, it's very important to put all the lines very close together so it creates nice and soft shading like this. And we're going to cross hatch it again like this. And we're going to cross hatch it like this here. And then we're going to try to place mouse. To place mouse, we have to look up and then try to placement from here to here approximately. That will be the end of the mouse. And this V shape here repeats itself in the mouse like this and this. And we're going to do top lip, going like this. And now we know we should go all the way up to here and a little bit darker in the corner. It's always darker in the corner of the lips, going like this. And the bottom of the lip. You could again check this way and shade all of this. So slowly we start to see the face. It's not a final version of it, but it's a preliminary sketch which we could correct. It's very important in sketching, you could never do things absolutely perfect from the first attempt. So you approximate first and then you try to correct it as you go. So we're going to put this all in the shadow like this. We're going to shade it down and we're going to shade all the way down this way to create better. And then from this, we're going to go all of this shadow over here. A little darker, you could go past the line over here like this and go and soften this line over here like that and back to this. Now what we could do, we could try to position our second eye. It is very important that both of the eyes will be approximately the same size. So if we start the eye from right here, we're going to see how much of a space we have, about that much space before we do the pupil of the eye. When we do this eye, it's very important you could actually put a line across like this and put a line across like this. So the eyes would be exactly on the same place. And then we're going to shade this. It's always better to do, when you do that, instead of doing it very round like this, to actually make it a little more geometric shapes, because it always ends up being more accurate. Then the shape of the eye continues going this way. And we do eyelid at the same time. We're going to go up like this. The shadow goes this way, like this. We're going to shade all of this, going like this, and a little bit darker close to the nose, softer edges, and eyebrow. Eyebrow, we're going to go like this, and then the direction of eyebrow changing, going this way, and all of this goes in a soft shadow, and soft shadow continues over here. And we're going to define the bottom of the eye. Now we should look how much of a light is left. It's about that much light left, and then we have a soft shadow on the bottom here. And then we have much more pronounced line. And again, we should look at, is it a thin line or it's a wider line? It's definitely a wider line, so we're going to go and put a wider line over here like that. And then now we could round it off a little bit, like this and this. You could also go back to this eye and round it off and make it a little more pronounced, soften all the shadows. And continue with a half shadow down on the nose, going like this. Then curve it a little bit and go like this. and straight it all very, very softly like this. Come back to this part of the nose, shade it like this. We're going to go back to the eye to define a little bit the shadow on this side. It's a little darker here, a little darker here. All of this is a half shadow, and then it becomes much, much darker going into here. And we're going to use cross hatching technique to make that. So going like this, going to go like this here, into the mustache area. All of this is darker, so we could go and shade a little bit more. Darker. And we're going to come back over here. And to put the shadow, to place it, we're going to look from the bottom of this, and we're going to line it up over here, so that would be an exact placement. It's going to have a very soft edge like this, going much, much darker to this side. Blends to the bottom, going around here, going like this. And we could at this point also very lightly shade this. And much darker over here with a cross-hatching technique. And we're going to sketch this a little darker. Then all of this also goes in a soft half shadow, so it's not as dark as our darkest shadow. We're going to go like this here. Soft shading. I'm going to go like this to define it a little better. Darker shadow on this side. I'm going to come back to this, and we're going to go back to the ear on this side. So the ear is only suggested here, but we still have to place it very, very accurately. So it will be about at that level over here, there would be shadow. And we could also look at the shape of it. So it looks like this, and that curves up, and this all goes in a shadow like that. But we have to look at the darkness of this. It's not as dark as the suit, which is much, much darker. So we could go back and darken that again a little bit. Darken this line over here. Look at this shape again, darken this a bit, darken this shape a little bit. Come back to the eyes, a little more definition to the eye, a little more definition to this area, a little darker over here, a little darker like this. Then we're going to soften the edge here, because it's not very good to have very sharp edges. And we're going to do half shadow on this side, going like this, and a little bit darker over here. This. So at this stage we have picture which is already well positioned and established the main shapes of the face. So we're going to continue that next time and define it more